Now, this is, I mean, you cannot speak about the Montessori system unless and until you know what is the absorbent mind. That is the mind of the child, known as the special mind. It is the mind between the age 0 to 6 years. Would you know that? Would you understand that? 0 to 6 years. Then it has been divided into two phases. The first is 0 to 3 and the second is 3 to 6. The name given to this mind, the 0 to 3 is known as the unconscious absorbent mind. Unconscious. 0, 3 to 6, conscious. Now, think about a newborn child who is one day old. Can that child talk? Say yes or no. A child who is one day old, can he talk?
No.
Can he walk?
No.
He can barely do anything, isn't it? And then think about a child who is 6 years old. What can a child who is 6 years old can do? Everything. Believe me, by that age, the child is able to walk, talk, read, write. He can do simple addition, subtraction, multiplication. According to Dr. Montessori, whatever a child learns from 0 to 6, it takes us from 6 to 60 years to learn that. And that's an amazing figure. Usually we say that the child is small. When he grows up, he will learn. It is not like that. So let us try to understand how this absorbent mind works. Okay? The definition is that the absorbent mind takes everything in totality. What is... Have you all ever seen a sponge? Everybody has seen a sponge?
Yes.
Okay, suppose I take a sponge and I put the sponge in this glass of water and press it. What will the sponge do? It will absorb the water completely. Now that is the characteristic, that is the quality of the absorbent mind. Whatever it comes in contact with, it takes it in totality. The absorbent mind does not have the ability to decide that this water is cold, I'm not going to take it. This water is dirty, I'm not going to take it up. It will only take it.
Your child is handicapped.
So, the child between the age 0 to 3, the quality of his mind is to absorb, take in things in totality. He is not going to say that, you know, this language is bad, I'm not going to pick it up. This is not good, he cannot decide. So it is for us to decide what we should expose the child to. Some real examples are, he thinks many things are not wrong and we do it. I'm giving you life examples so that you don't even come across, you don't read it in a book, it's a one-on-one sharing. When my little son was about 6 months old, I would take banana, mash it, and give it to him to eat, mashed bananas. And in the end, little bit would be left. And while he was eating, I would take that mashed banana and apply it as a face mask. Right there in front of him, a 6-month-old baby. One day, as he grew a little older, 9 months, I had given him the banana to eat and I went in the kitchen to do something else. When I came back, guess what he had done? After eating, He applied it on the face because he had seen me do it. So something that I didn't think was wrong at all, something that I didn't think he will pick up, but he did. Now I am going to tell you something about this absorbent mind. Personally, I call it a dangerous mind. Imagine if there is like this camera जो आपको हर वक्त कैप्चर कर रहा है, तो डोंट वी बिकम कॉन्शियस? मेनी टाइम्स आई एम अलोन इन द हाउस, आई एम वॉचिंग टीवी, आई एम जस्ट रिलैक्स लाइंग ऑन द बेड ईटिंग समथिंग, आई एम वेरी केयरलेसली सिटिंग डाउन इफ आई एम अलोन एंड इफ आई सडनली फाइंड आउट somebody is coming, oh my father is coming in the room, what is our immediate reaction? We will sit properly, because when now we know somebody is watching. So that is what you should keep in your mind. Whenever there is a child around you, how many of you are conscious in the presence of a child? How many? In fact, let me ask you a question. How many of you all are blessed with children? कितने किसी के बच्चे हैं? Are you married? Child? No, nobody has a child sitting here. Can you hear me? आपको मेरी आवाज आ रही?
Yes.
Anybody has a child?
Yes.
You have. Okay. How old is your child? 10 years. Oh, so you must have done lots of mistakes while he was growing up. I am sure, right? Because you see, what happens, we say that, you know, again and again I will use this expression that abhi to chota hai, abhi to bachcha hai. I mean, you know, I'll be more careful. I know mothers who change their clothes in front of little babies who are sitting in the cot. Bachcha hai.
For all such things.
But remember, you have a memory. Do we all have a memory? You are hearing my lecture today. You may remember certain facts and you may forget certain facts. We usually think this is small child between the age 0 to 3. अभी तो बच्चा है, बड़े होके से कौन सा याद रहेगा? आप में से किसी को बचपन की 3 साल एज से पहले की कोई बात याद है? No. Impossible. बार बार आपकी मम्मी रोज आपको सुनाती हो तो वो और बात है. You will know it as a story, but you won't remember it. Do you know why?
It is the child who learns everything from his senses.
Because a child between the age 0 to 3 years does not have a memory. I mean, when I discovered that fact, I was amazed. Huh? They don't have a memory? So a child, 2.5-year-old child, I am telling him this rhyme and so on. So, and if he does not have a memory, what happens? They have something which is even more powerful than a memory. Because when we have a memory, we can forget. My lecture, you will remember certain things and you will forget the other things. But with the child between the age 0 to 3, he does not have a memory, so he does not remember. And when you don't remember, you don't forget. What happens? It is incarnated into his personality. It becomes him, the child. And that is so true. Nazra Amri, her little baby girl, day one, suppose she, her baby girl, and I go to China, and she meets us after 6 years. Now, focus and try to understand. This is summarizing life. Her child, she carried for 9 months, and it is her genes, her husband's genes. Yet, the child grew up 6 years away from her environment.
and those powers.
Would the child have anything like Nazra Amri? Yes or no?
We are going to use it at the right time, right age.
No.
Will
she speak like her?
Will
she like eat the same food like her? Will she dress like her? No. Because while the child was absorbing during the age 0 to 6 years, her lifestyle was not present. Children are not born with that. Children are born with the color of the eyes, the hair and all that. But the other things, many times we say, oh, she talks just like her mother. Oh, she walks just like his. He and his father, look how they are looking identical. That is because the child has seen that. And there could be nothing more clear and simple example than how the child's absorbent mind works is the accusation of a spoken language. I mean, the more you think about it, the more miraculous it becomes. Just because it happens every time, nobody takes it on seriously. Any of you, do you have a child who was born and you could speak in first day? No, no. Do you think about these facts? That why did God let the human child take so long to be able to develop a language and learn to speak? Why couldn't a human baby talk like the animal babies? Ducks, cows, goats, birds, they can speak immediately after birth. But what language do they speak? A cat speaks like a? A cat speaks like a? Mother cat, right? Can a cat speak like a dog? No, and the answer is no. No much, no much technology, whether the cat grows up in Pakistan, India, China, anywhere, the cat will speak like a cat. Because God has not given the animals the quality. They are born with preordained. They don't have an absorbent mind. But God gifted the human child with a special mind. That you go to the world and you take in anything that you wish. We are only going to be focusing on the language. Now let us look at the language that our children speak. Do they all speak Urdu, basically, in Karachi, most houses? Why? They listen to Urdu, so they speak Urdu. I'm making it really simple. Baby talk, lecture day. Right? They listen to Urdu, so they speak Urdu.
You will treat to them.
Then, not only do they do that, they listen to Urdu being spoken in different accent. Urdu is spoken with Punjabi accent. Urdu is spoken with Sindhi accent. Urdu is spoken with Bihari accent. A child, how does he become that? Who tells him to do that? Huh? I mean, when Nazra speaks, she speaks like, ha, hamare na. We know that she's not a typical Urdu speaking. That leja. I mean, sochi. Where did she get that? She must have picked up that from the absorbent mind period 0 to 6. It may have seems to diminish, it may seems to, but that minute, that will remain there permanently. That's why the first language the child speaks and is spoken to is known as your mother tongue. Afterwards, you may learn many languages, but you will not have the fluency in it. Now, some secrets about what you can do to expose your child to languages, because now you know the child has an absorbent mind and he can take everything in totality. Imagine, think about a planet where they tell you you can just learn simply by walking and listening. Wouldn't you love that? Okay, you tell me, you want to learn French. Can you learn to speak French? Simply by hearing it? Yes? You can speak French by hearing it? No. But yes, no, se hame pata chal jayega na ki kiska mind zyada special hai. Do we have to go to special classes? Huh? Come on, pick up girls, this is bad manners. Do we have to go to special classes? Agar French seekhna hai, to French seekhne ke liye aapko kisi special class jaane ki zarurat hai? Translation mein yaad cheezon ko karne ki zarurat hai? Consult dictionary karne ki zarurat hai, theek hai? But hum to special hai, hum to adult hai, hame to sab kuch pata hai. वो तो बच्चा है जिसे कुछ भी नहीं पता, सही है ना? यही हमारी सोच है ना? तो फिर वो बच्चा कोई जबान कैसे सीख लेता? How does a child learn to speak a language without going to any special coaching center, without having a dictionary, without having? सोचे इस बात पे, सोचे. फूलिश है, बेवकूफ है ना? बच्चे तो बच्चे हैं, उनको तो कुछ नहीं आता है, हमें आता है, तो वो ये ज़बान कैसे सीख लेता है? और किस तरह सीखता है? परफेक्शन. नो मदर सिट्स डाउन के बोलो मैं, मेरा नाम अंजुम है, मेरा नाम अंजुम है, मेरा नाम अंजुम है, मेरा नाम अंजुम है. हम इस तरह तो नहीं सिखाते हैं ज़बान किसी को. बल्कि कुछ बच्चे जिनके घर में चार भाई हैं और एक बहन है, तो वो शी टॉक्स लाइक मैं आ रहा हूँ, मैं जा रहा हूँ. सो द लैंग्वेज इज एब्सॉर्ब्ड इन टोटालिटी. व्हाट यू हियर इज व्हाट यू रिप्रोड्यूस. इफ द चाइल्ड लिसन्स टू गुड हेल्दी लैंग्वेज, ही विल स्पीक गुड हेल्दी लैंग्वेज. The beauty about the absorbent mind is the child can learn 1, 2, 3, 4, more than 4, 5 languages effortlessly. So what should you do? Let me get an answer. What should you do now that you know that children are absorbing language from the environment aur ye do teen zaban easily seekh lete hain? To aapka kya farz hai? Aapko kya karna chahiye? Aap bataye? Koi bhi bataye. We should take advantage of it, na? Like, speak, if the mother could speak English, let her speak to the child in English. If the grandmother can let the child speak to the grandmother in English, when the maid is coming home, let her speak to the child in Saraiki or Sindhi. Kheli khelbe, your child will learn three languages. But unfortunately, I have my own case, and as I said, I'm sharing life experiences. My own elder sister, she could speak English very well, fluent. When she had her first child, she didn't know Montessori, but she spoke to the child in English. And all her in-laws and family members made so much fun of her. ओहो भाभी को तो बड़े ये हैं, भाभी तो इंग्लिश में बच्चों से बात करती हैं. वो शी वाज सो अशेम्ड एंड एम्बैरस्ड दैट शी स्टॉप्ड टॉकिंग टू देम इन इंग्लिश. आज वन ऑफ हर डॉटर इज अ डॉक्टर, सन इज अ पीएचडी, लेकिन उनको इंग्लिश बोलने में वो फ्लुएंसी नहीं है. इट्स अ फॉरेन लैंग्वेज फॉर हर. काश अगर वो लोगों का ख्याल नहीं करती और उनसे इंग्लिश में उस एज पे बोलती, द एब्सॉर्बेंट माइंड पीरियड, they could have spoken English with the perfection. Unfortunately, we are so conscious of the other environment, other people in the house, that we, even after knowing, like you are a Montessorian, suppose you do know the child's absorbent mind, but still you are shy, you are afraid, people make fun of you, that you are doing this and you are allowing the child to do that. But please remember that this time, 0 to 3 and 3 to 6 will never come back in the life of the child. Now, why Dr. Maria Montessori divided this special absorbent mind into two minds? Why not only from 0 to 6? She's calling one unconscious and one the conscious. So what is the difference? What is the difference? Do we? जब बोलने को कहते हैं तो कोई नहीं बोलता. एंड व्हेन वी से टू लिसन टू द लेक्चर, खामोशी से लेक्चर सुने तो एवरीबॉडी इज लाइक, एक्चुअली स्मॉल ग्रुप ना तो सबकी शक्ल नजर आ रही है यहाँ पे, तो किसी कोई किसी की बोलने की हिम्मत ही नहीं होगी, ना कोई सेल्फी ले रहा. ओके, रिमेम्बर आई स्टार्टेड ऑफ के थिंक ऑफ द चाइल्ड 0 years, कुछ नहीं कर सकता बच्चा रोने के अलावा, एंड यू नो दूसरी चीजों के अलावा कुछ खा लिया एंड सो ऑन, बट द चाइल्ड कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग. He takes in everything in totality. How many of you have ever shifted? कभी किसी ने घर shift किया है? Shifting की है? Basically what we do when we shift is that हर चीज को pack करते हैं, जो नया वाला घर होता है, when we go there, हम बीच हॉल में सब चीज को डंप कर देते हैं. जो ट्रक लाता है आपकी सारी चीजें, सोफा, डाइनिंग टेबल, कपड़े, सब एक जगह डंप कर देते हैं. फिर जब आपकी थकान खत्म होती है, दिन में ज्यादा एनर्जी है, दे एबल टू थोड़ी देर के ब्रेक के बाद चीजों को समेटना शुरू करते हैं, जगह पे रखते हैं, यू मे डू इट द नेक्स्ट डे एंड सो ऑन.